cricket, there are two main categories of bowlers. First, the pace bowlers or the fast bowlers, and second are the spin bowlers or the spinners. Pacers can be further divided into fast bowlers and swing bowlers, whereas spin bowlers can be further divided into wrist spinners and finger spinners. Today, in this video, we will take a look at the science behind the mechanism of swing. Stay tuned till the end for an interesting story about Sachin Tendulkar and Rahul Dravid. To understand the cricket ball aerodynamics, we first have to understand the structure of the cricket ball. Let's take a closer look. A cricket ball is made up of cork covered by a leather shell. The two halves of the leather shell are stitched by a string, and this is known as the seam. This raised seam of six rows of stitching gives the ball a number of unique aerodynamic qualities and help determine its swing and spin. The sides of the ball degrade with use, but to give a ball more swing, the fielding side usually allows one side to roughen up while keeping the other side smooth and shiny. The rough side of the ball deteriorates and becomes dull due to repeated contact with the pitch and the bat. Before going into details of it, let's look at the three possible scenarios. When one side is rough and one side is shiny, you will get maximum swing effect. When both sides are shiny, you will see ambiguous movement. When both sides are rough, there will be no swing. Now we look at the swing of a new ball, or better known as conventional swing. The swing of a new ball depends on the angle in which you place the seam of the ball. If the orientation of the seam is straight in the direction of the throw, then the ball won't swing at all, it'll go straight. To swing the ball, the seam must be at an angle. If the angle of the seam is tilted left, like this, then ball will swing towards left, and if the seam angle is tilted right, like this, then the ball will swing towards the right. Or you can say, if the seam is tilted towards the batsman, then the ball will swing towards the batsman. It is then called the in-swing. Similarly, when the seam is tilted away from the batsman, then the ball will go outwards and it's called the outswing. Now let's have a look at the science behind the swing. When the ball travels through the air, it divides the air into two parts. The shiny side, being smoother, allows the air to move faster with less friction. The smoother airflow of this side is called laminar airflow. The rough side, on the other hand, due to greater friction, causes the air to move slower and in a more turbulent way. This is called turbulent airflow. The velocity of the laminar airflow is more than the turbulent airflow. And here comes in the Bernoulli's principle. Bernoulli's principle states that as the speed of a moving fluid increases, the pressure within the fluid decreases. Therefore, according to this principle, the difference of velocity between laminar airflow and turbulent airflow causes a difference in air pressure as well. Hence, the rougher side has more air pressure than the smoother one, and due to this effect, the ball moves in the curved path instead of the straight line. This effect is also called the Magnus effect. Let's talk about reverse swing now. Pioneers and notable practitioners of reverse swing have mostly been Pakistani fast bowlers. Imran Khan is rightly regarded as one of the first and finest exponents of reverse swing. Where conventional swing bowling can be done at a medium to medium fast bowling speeds, reverse swing generally requires a bowler to generate a very good pace, typically 140 km per hour and above. Another important factor in reverse swing is the roughness of the ball, especially how it varies between each side. The greater the shine, that is minimal wear and tear, on one side, and the roughness, that is more wear and tear on the other, the better are the chances of generating a reverse swing. Simply put, in case of reverse swing, a delivery that the batsman expects to be an outswinger becomes an in-swinger. This is why a good reverse swing bowler has high dismissals in the form of bold and LBWs. This happens when the bowler angles the seam for a conventional swing, but in this case, the rough side of the ball with more wear and tear faces the batsman. If this ball is bowled quick enough, even the laminar layer transcends into the turbulent state before it reaches the seam, that is, before the ball hits the ground for a bounce. The seam over here has a reverse effect. It alters the turbulent layer so it breaks off earlier at the surface of the ball's top than the bottom. Here, the lateral force created due to this differential pressure acts in the reverse direction as compared to how it would have been in a conventional swing. Many cricketers in the past have tried to tamper with the ball to make it more favorable for reverse swing. This includes rubbing a ball with foreign material like sandpaper, chewing gum or lozenges. Some cricketers have even tried to bite the seam off the ball for this purpose. They have faced match bans or penalties for this behavior. Moreover, ball tampering with artificial substances is illegal according to the laws of cricket affixed by the ICC. Before leaving, let me tell you an interesting story which was told by Sachin Tendulkar in an interview. Rahul Dravid and Sachin Tendulkar were playing a match against New Zealand in Mohali and Chris Cairns was bowling. The ball was reverse swinging and Cairns beat them several times. Both of them were clueless and couldn't see the shiny side of the ball. Then Sachin figured out the way of reading a swing. What they did was, the non-striker was observing the bowler and the non-striker would hold the bat in the left hand in case the shiny side was towards the left, and the non-striker would hold the bat in the right hand when the shiny side of the ball was on the right side. This strategy worked and Rahul placed some beautiful boundaries. Having lost momentum, Cairns bowled a cross-seam delivery, that is, holding the ball across the seam, to Dravid, but he didn't realize Sachin also had plans for that. He told Dravid that if I don't know what is coming, I'm going to hold the bat in the middle. Instead of looking at Rahul or checking what has happened there, Cairns, however, looked at Tendulkar and asked him straight, "What have you got for this?" So next time you pick up the ball to bowl, hopefully you'll send the stumps flying with an unplayable in-swinger. Let us know if you'd like to know more such interesting facts. Hit the subscribe button and don't forget to press the bell icon.